I've never always had this glowing, clear, beautiful skin. It was up until like 2 years ago, I realized that people that were really looking really that good was not like it was they fell from the sky or they woke up that way. There are people that have invested so much into their looks that understood some things I was not understanding. So I feel this is the point of this video, and I hope I will transcend this information and that turning point for me to somebody. I'm going to put before pictures as to what my face and my skin is to look like, because I could do the best makeup, but when I started doing the right things, I get more of the "wow, I prefer you without makeup" kind of comments, like I said. So this video is just me walking you through the things I changed, the things I stopped, the things I started incorporating. And trust me, these were the real deal. They took my look from 100, from a 0 to 100. I'll be asking, what's your skincare like? Oh, I like your this. And certain features of my face and my body, like my lips, exactly my lips. When I started like doing what I was doing more, I was getting more complex. "Oh, I love your eyes, I love your lips." And I was like, where have they have this thing? These things has been literally here all the time. Did they change in shape? Did something happen? But it really taught me a lesson. Like, if you don't invest in self-care, in yourself, nobody's going to do it for you. Beauty can actually increase or it can decrease. It's dependent on the person who wears the face, who wears the body, and how much you're willing to invest your time, your money, your knowledge, and just doing the right thing. So the first thing to like I really had to do to elevate the looks and everything was skincare. Your skin is like the largest organ on your body. That's what people are going to notice first and foremost. It's the first thing they will notice. "Oh, you have good skin, you have glowing skin." Some may not notice it, but it's just this thing about you and they can't place it. I feel to get that kind of skin tone, to get the attention and really bring your beauty out, is to have a very bright skin. People say they are dark skin. I don't mean you need to bleach. Whatever complexion you have, there's a brighter hue to that complexion. And if you've neglected your skin so much and you've gone out, example, into the sun a lot, you will get a tan, a darker version of your true complexion. And it just dims your face, dims your light, and nobody knows if anything is going on. But your true complexion, if you have a brighter version of it, it's like, well, anything that is bright is attractive, is beautiful. So I would say investing in and building a very, very sensible skincare is the first and number one key. I'm quite aware you'll be seeing a lot of products, people using so many things on the internet. "Oh, this is my skincare routine. This is this. You should do this for acne prone skin. You should do that for dry skin." But with all my research and my experience and everything, I found out the key to really having good, glowing, bright skin is to make sure your skin is hydrated at all times. This cut across to whatever skin type you are, wherever you find yourself in the world. This is the basic and number one key rule to make the cells of your skin really breathe and really serve you. If you have dry skin, if your skin is not properly hydrated, it's going to get really rough, scaly, bumpy, have some rough textures. Same vein, if you have oily skin, when your skin is not properly hydrated, it's going to try to make up for this lack of moisture by overproducing oil. When it's overproducing oil, which is sebum, it comes in contact with oxygen and it becomes whitehead or blackhead, which clog your pores over time and becomes breakout, which you pick and they become scars and dark spots and all of that. So the Reef Foundation is preventing anything, and by giving the skin what it needs, you don't need to break the bank, you don't need all this complex skincare, just get your foundation right. And luckily enough, I have an in-depth video on how to start as a beginner, the skincare, how to hydrate the skin. I'm going to put the video in the card here, which is this video, and I'm going to place it in the card here. Just click it, it will appear below this one, and you can go watch it after you're done watching this video. And also, another thing is masking. Applying mask is very, very, very important. Very important. There's one masking come in variety of ways. You could buy mask and you could DIY mask. I do both. If you're on this channel, the mask I like to buy is called the clay mask, and I have two of those masks, the bentonite clay and the bentonite clay from Simple Cosmetics and the Azet Healing Clay Mask. Clay masking to me is a very powerful mask. It has the ability to draw out impurities from deep within your pores. So I use it weekly and as a preventive basis. So we go out into the sun, we go out into polluted atmosphere, we touch our face all the time, we sweat, and so many impurities that would have built up that could cause breakouts in the future or something. So using a clay mask weekly will just help to go ahead of time and prevent those things from happening. The next is turmeric mask. You guys know how I live and die for turmeric mask. Turmeric mask is a very powerful mask. It is an Ayurvedic practice, which means a beauty tool that has been used for thousands of years. The Indians swear by this. In Nigeria, sir, before a bride gets married, it's part of the skin polishing processes. Turmeric is mixed with it could be mixed with honey, it can be mixed with yogurt, but when done correctly, it has the ability to brighten your skin, it has the ability to get rid of dark spots, it has the ability to get rid of pimples, acne. It gives a smooth and really glowing skin over time, so long you are consistent. I'm going to link a video here on one of the many ways I incorporate turmeric into my facial treatments and all of that. Another thing is sunscreen. The sun is the number one culprit in reducing and degrading our beauty over time. And all of us go out in the sun every day, at least every week, no matter how you want to be a vampire. You go out in the sun, and the sun causes darkness, it causes premature aging and everything. So it's better to prevent and to like protect your skin from the harmful rays of the sun by using a sunscreen. The least SPF you should use is SPF 50, because this cuts across all the broad spectrum, all the harmful rays of the sun. And when you protect your skin, it serves you. It's better to protect than to be threatened when it has gone wrong. Say can raises anybody's look a top notch and 100% is your teeth, because you're going to be talking a lot, you're going to be smiling. If you have brown yellow teeth, it's going to like zap the energy of how good you look, and just make that's what people are going to focus on. Funny enough, there are many, many ways you can whiten your teeth. I'm the queen of that. I was not having the perfect teeth before, till I started incorporating and researching on a lot of things. And I found out the hydrogen peroxide, the baking soda, and the potato recipe, which I'm going to also link in the card. You can go click that video. Just click them, they will appear below this one. And know how I put all those things together to whiten the teeth. So I focused on whitening my teeth completely natural, no need to waste any money or anything. It's not going to be like snow white 100% in your face, but it's very effective. Another thing I like to use as a weekly prevention sometimes is black activated charcoal. Everyone can get access to it. It's really cheap and everything, and it really helps to brighten the teeth. The third one is your lips. The lips is the part of the skin that gets accumulates dead skin cells so fast, like in one day. So you have to be constantly exfoliating it to get rid of those dead skin cells. If you can't buy lip scrubs, I have a lot of video on my channel on how to make lip scrubs. But a simple trick you can do is the toothbrush trick. I do this when I'm like lazy and I don't want all the messiness the lip scrub brings. I just put some olive oil on a clean toothbrush. I make sure that toothbrush is always clean and it's for that purpose only. And I use it to scrub my lips gently. And it just boosts blood flow to your lips. It looks plump, it's soft, smooth, and really attractive. Because a dark lips is just going to make you look like a smoker, and it's just going to dim the light of your beauty again. So to me, I've mentioned a glowing skin, a white teeth, a darkness-free lips that is soft and smooth, and yeah, perfect. To me, these are the three basic foundation of really looking pretty without makeup on. If you get your skincare right, your teeth is not brown and dirty, and your lips is smooth and really sensible, you are going to like be transformed. All those videos I've given you, especially the ones in the card, if you go watch them and incorporate everything I said there, all you just need is consistency, patience, and literally in a month or less than a month, you'll begin to see a difference to what you used to look like. I'm going to put like before pictures to what I used to look like, because I neglected all these three important things. They're just little things people ignore because nobody cares, or they just feel it doesn't add up, but they are actually the real foundation to everything. Pay attention to your skin, your teeth, and also try not to worry too much in life. Everybody has problems. We just smile. People don't let you see through it. Don't be so worried to the extent you think you're the only one having all the problems in the world. You're not, actually. Things will always pass. Just know that if you believe in God, be prayerful to God. Don't take anything to heart. Don't be worried, because again, the body will secrete some hormones that are going to make you age faster than you're supposed to be. And also, what you consume matters. You are what you eat. So try to feed the body of really good food, because there are some vitamins that are for the skin and all of that. Another deep secret of mine that have really transformed my skin, and I don't joke with it, is rubbing cucumber slices before bed. I legit sometimes do this every single day. Some weeks I don't do it at all. Some weeks I do it once a day. That thing is life. I'm not even joking, and I'm not even kidding. Rubbing cucumber slices on your face before bedtime and waking up to wash it up, it transformed my skin so much. It transformed my skin 100%. Cucumber contains salicylic acid. I'm not sure. I'm going to put the name on the screen, which helps to break down dead skin cells and any gang on the surface of your skin that causes dullness of complexion and have just accumulated over time. It breaks them down. That acid, it brightens the skin. It hydrates the skin because it has high water content. It gets rid of pimples, acne, and a lot and bunch of stuff. Another thing I like to use to get really glowing skin is the Pixies Glow Tonic. If you want to wow people and you want to like make sure your skin glows in 5 minutes, use the Pixie Glow Tonic. That thing contains glycolic acids, again, which helps to break down dead skin cells that have accumulated to cause dull complexion. It also contains a substance that boosts blood flow almost immediately within minutes of applying it to the face, and this gives us radiant glow, which I have it on because it's necessary for me to glow in this video. So yeah, these are my simple little tricks that really help to boost my appearance over time from what it was compared to now. Yeah, I hope you learned something. Don't forget to like this video. It makes me know the kind of videos you guys like. Hit the subscribe button below if you haven't subscribed to this channel yet. And comment below if you have any questions and anything, just comment below. I reply to all of my comments, provided it needs reply. So until next time, guys. Bye.